Hi guys, it's tanyaleigh here from tanyaleigh designs. Finally doing a video, and this one is a vintage haul video. I haven't done a haul video before because I don't tend to buy a lot of stuff, but over the last few months, or just, you know, like just before Christmas, and yeah, so since Christmas till now, I've been collecting a few bits and pieces of vintage ephemera, old laces, envelopes, all those sorts of things. And I just wanted to share with you today because I scored some pretty cool things, and I wanted to show you guys. Since I put up my first junk journal video, the first journal that I made, I've had a few more subscribers join, and obviously you like the junk journals, so I thought that I would show you my little goodies that I've collected over the time. So I'll get into it. So first of all, I'll show you the laces that I got. I got this big bag of laces. Now here in New Zealand, I can't find a lot of laces and bits and pieces at our second hand shops. We call them second hand shops. Some of you guys overseas call them thrift stores. So like, I asked a lady the other day at the second hand shop, and she said that it's not really something that they get in, which seems odd because they have, you know, like other things that are in the same line of laces, like sewing stuff and bits and pieces. But anyway, this bag I got off a website here in New Zealand called Trade Me. It's an auction site. You can either buy now, they have a buy now price, which is normally more than their auction price start at, like maybe a dollar reserve. But this lady wanted $9 for the whole bag, so I bought it and I thought it was pretty cool. So we'll get started, because I have a buttload of stuff, not just in this bag, but to show you. So I'm not sure if this will be just a really long video or a two-part, but anyway. So first up in this bag of laces, I got this. It's a bluey, I don't know if you can see on camera or not, and I don't want to go too close because my camera's, I don't know, it's just a normal camera, it's nothing flash, so I don't know if it's gonna focus. But it's a really, really nice sheer lace. So I got quite a bit of that, so I was pretty chuffed with that. I got this, which is awesome. This is very vintagey, and it's got pearls on it. I don't know if it's sewn, if they're all, I presume they're all sewn on. Yes, they are all sewn on. Glad it wasn't me that was doing that. So there's a maybe meter of that. So there's that. There's this one. This actually looks like curtain lace or curtain fabric, but it's got wee ducks and wee, you know, the greenery in the pond, you know. But there's wee ducks along. I thought that was quite cute. So there's a bit of that. I've got that. Let's put that back over that. I got some of this. It's tied in a knot at one end. It looks like a shoelace, but it's not. Oh, I know what it is. It's that. Oh, maybe. Hang on. Give me 1 second. Is it gonna? I've seen this stuff that you can get at like a bead shop, and it's like a netting, like a tube of netting that you can stick your beads in, but I'm not sure if I can. It is double layered, so maybe that's what I'm not sure, but anyway, it will come in handy for something, I'm sure. So let's put that on this piece of card. There's a couple of, there's that little tiny one. and there's a little bit of that, and then this. So there's that. And there's a tiny, there 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's 7 of these little flowers. So 7 of those. Oh, and there's some more of the blue, that blue one that I showed you at the beginning. Some more of that. There's 4 of those. Oui, appliques. And this is very, very vintage. It looks like it's been sitting in someone's stash box for many, many years. It's very, very old. But it's very nice. There's a few little dings in it, but I don't care. It just adds to the vintageness of something. So that will be really cool on a junk journal, I'm sure. So there's that little bit. What have we got here? This looks like bridal lace. Not 100. That's very cool. I am absolutely crazy about laces. I am such a girly girl. I love pink, I love glitter, I love bling, I love all sorts of stuff, and I love lace, and I always have. And even if I don't use it, it just sits there and looks pretty. So there's this as well. So I've got a bit of that. And this is definitely vintage. It's tied up with a rubber band. Just let me take that off. I'm not sure that I think. Oh, this was must have been attached to like maybe a nightie, because it's got this little satin bit here that it's been cut. So I might go along and actually get my unpick and take it actually off. So it's definitely off an item of clothing. It's very old. There's that. There's this, which reminds me of the 70s, because I was born in the 70s. It looks like something off a curtain that you hang over your kitchen windows. So I'm not sure what I'll use this on, but I'm sure I will find something, maybe, maybe not. I've got this. Sorry, I've just got something in my eye. Yes, I know, it's my finger. this looks like a two. Oh, here we go. So it's like a eyelet lace at the top, and then it's got two rows of gathered lace under it. So there's heaps of that, so that's cool. This, this is definitely vintage as well. The auction actually said that it was like just laces and some of it was vintage, so definitely, yes, some of it's vintage and some of it's not, but it's lace, so gotta love it. Oops, my beads are flying everywhere. And I have maybe 2 meters, meter and a half of this type of little lace. It's pretty. And this lace is very common. I had it years and many years ago when I was doing my sewing, and all sorts of colors. I think I've actually got some lace here that I bought like this many moons ago, and I got it for like 5 cents a meter because they were getting rid of it, but it was a mauvey, real lilac mauvey type of colour, and I hate the colour purple mauve, so I dyed it and it's now cream. I'm not sure where that is, but anyway, but it's, yeah, it's a very common pattern lace, so there's that. So there's quite a bit of that to use, so that's good. Oops. There's this is stretchy lace, which is quite good if you're going to use it like a belly band or something around a journal, because it's stretchy. This stuff reminds me of knickers and bras and stuff, because that's what they use on knickers. But anyway, there's a little bit of that. There's this, which is definitely vintage. It looks like lace that you'd find on a christening gown or something like that. It's a creamy colour, this is maybe about a metre and a half or a metre of that. I've got some black, which is cool, so there's that, there's a buttload of that. So there's that, and there is this type of lace, and there's a buttload of that as well. It's quite pretty. This one, which is vintage and it's really wide. Go this way. So there. And then the scallopy bits at the bottom. So that's really pretty. And there's a bit of that too, so. And in this little bundle here, we have this little bit. So there's a tiny bit of that, there's a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of this, and there's a little bit of this. This is cute. I'm not sure if it's the same as the other. No, it's not. It's different. There's that. So there's those three. Then there was this, which is cool, it's really, really wide. So there's that. It's a sheer type lace. There's quite a bit of that too. Oh, look at this. I love this. It is just, it's like tulle on the back. And then just lots of bits sewn to it, so it's a really, really wide, really, really wide, but it's beautiful. So it's probably maybe not quite a meter on that. I like that one. Then there's this one. And there's maybe a metre and a half of that one. There's one of these. Little bit of this, who remembers this lace? The multicoloured lace. Very pretty. And there's not even a metre of that. And then this is definitely vintage. Very, very cool. It's a blue, baby blue and white toned lace. And a little bit of this. This is very delicate. There's not much of that either, but that's okay. And this is a creamy lace. Wide. Oops, the edge. Maybe a couple of meters of that too. And then the last one is a peachy colour. And that's pretty too. And I think that's a very common pattern too for lace. Pretty. So that's all my laces. I'll just quickly stuff them back in the bag that they came in. And then I'll show you some other bits. So the other bits, excuse the crinkling, the other bits that I got, like I said, are off Trade Me. in the second hand shop around the corner. I've had some vintage Happy Mail sent to me. I've got a Happy Mail group that I run on Facebook, and we send Happy Mail all over the world, which is absolutely fantastic. Excuse me, I'm just going to have a drink. And we send Happy Mail all over the world. I'm just going to show you the page if you want to sneak over and join up. Facebook has changed something since I was last on there. Just let me find the group and I'll show you on the camera. So this group was originally Renee's group, which used to be Hey Nay Daily Happy Mail group. She has since moved on to other things and she handed the group over to me. I was helping her for a little bit while she moved and stuff like that. So the name's changed because it's not her group anymore. So it's named Happy Mailers group, or Happy Mailers, and this is it here. So if you see that header, you will be in the right place if you want to join the group. We send Happy Mail all over the world to different people, and we also do swaps. At the moment we're running an Easter swap, which people have already sent and received and stuff like that. So if you want to get involved in that, then head over there. So oopsie. This is just one of my little Easter things I'm doing. Right, anyway, change subject. Right, next bit. This pile of goodies here I picked up from Trade Me. They are index cards and the dividers, so ABC, you can't see, but or you might be able to see, yeah, ABCD and all that. Now they're actually bigger than the normal index cards, which is really cool. They're definitely vintage, so I've got that pile. So there is a good fair whack of index cards there, and with it came a pile of these, which are more dividers, but then there's, I don't know why, I don't know what the purpose of these ones were, because it says KA, KB, KC, so it's obviously ABC, I don't know, I really don't know, but and then you've got like D800, D900 on them. It's just really weird, but they are shorter dividers, but anyway, but very cool vintage things. I could make even a journal out of these. So I got them. I think they were $8 for the whole lot, which I didn't think was too bad. But the postage was more because of the weight of it all, because it is quite heavy. But that's okay. I managed. Excuse the crinkling, because I haven't taken out a bag yet. But I've stored these. Oops. One fell on the floor, but that's okay. I managed to buy these off a Facebook group for New Zealand crafty stash group. So these are the Hooks and Eyes, vintage Hooks and Eyes. So I think I paid $6 for all this. Oh, excuse me, which I didn't think was too bad. So I'll definitely be scanning these and using them, because I do, I've got my own business, which is designing my own scrapbooking embellishments, and I'm into the vintage thing now, and I'm going to be doing, well, I've actually started. I've got one of my paper kits up at the moment on my website, tanyaleighdesigns.co.nz. The link will be down below, so for my website, so you can check it out. But I will be doing lots of different bits and pieces. I am working on it. You can't see because it's all behind the scenes while I'm working on it, but things are being designed and created and will be getting put up. I've got so much on, but that is getting done. So I've managed to get those, which I thought was pretty cool. I managed to get this little pack of goodies from another Trade Me purchase. I got some pinking chairs, some vintage pinking chairs. They are absolutely amazing and in awesome condition. They cut like butter. Now I've got a piece, I've already cut it, but I've got a piece of felt here. And seriously, it cuts like butter. It is so cool. I have wanted a pair of pinking shears for years. Like I said earlier, I was into sewing and all that back when I first got married, and I always wanted a pair, but they're not cheap to buy, and I managed to score these off Trade Me for $11, so I didn't think that was too bad. And then the lady that sells these sells lots of different vintage things, and she had this on Trade Me, and I got it for $1. It's a wee tin, and it says domes, hooks, and eyes on it. So obviously some little old lady, or a little old man, had this in their wee stash. There's some hooks and eyes and some buttons and bits and pieces, and then the old tin. Thought that was pretty cute. So I got that. A bookshop around the corner from here. It's not a bookshop. It's just a... Anyway, it's a bookshop. Worth explaining. I managed to pick up a ton of envelopes. They're all different sizes, they're all different colours. There's some little ones, like little note card ones here. And I got this whole lot for I think it was $6 maybe? I'm not sure, but there's a ton. There's square ones, there's different ones, different paper that they're made out of. This one's got stripies on it. So yeah, they will be great for sending happy mail. great for tea and coffee staining, and using in my journal. Some of them are a little bit bigger than others, so maybe I could fold them in half or something like that. I'm not 100% sure, so but we'll see what happens with those, but they were a good find. And this shop always has them, and so I just keep going back and buying more, because who doesn't love envelopes, right? This little pile of goodies here was from a lady on my Happy Mail group. I like vintage things, and in the Happy Mail group we actually do a wee profile, and then people can go in and have a look at your profile and see the things that you like, and then they can send you things. And so I like vintage and shabby chic and all the old things. And so I got this lovely surprise in the mail one day, and it was full of all this old vintage ephemera and bits and pieces. So yeah, so some old envelopes, an old card, some game piece, some game record papers, some notepaper. And then this is just a selection of cards, some stickies, sticky shapes, some envelopes, some more cards, another card, another piece of paper, and some postcards. So that was nice of her to send me. So that was a really nice surprise to get that in the mail. And it also came with this really cute clip with a flamingo on it. It was really cute. So yeah, I've got those goodies from a lady on the group. I managed to score this from Trade Me. This was $9, so it was a little bit on the dear side, but they are old ephemera pharmacy labels, vintage pharmacy labels. They definitely haven't been stuck, well, haven't been used at all, so they're new. So I thought that was really cool and something to have and scan in and use. So yeah, I thought they were really cool. So got those. These next things are tickets, are vintage bus pass tickets. Now these, like I live in Auckland, but prior to that, my whole life, pretty much I lived in Christchurch, but I moved north after all the earthquakes that Christchurch had. I just couldn't cope with them, so I moved. But anyway, these are from Christchurch Transport Board, and they were the bus tickets that were used back in the day for students to get on the buses. So some, this one's 1991, so this was a monthly bus pass for the month of February. This one was effective from the 23rd of May 1989. So yeah, I think it's really cool that actually they're from Christchurch, and I can have, you know, use them in my journals, and it's actually from Christchurch. So this is just another one. I don't think there's a date on this one. There's no date on this one either, and this one's 89 as well, so they're all obviously around the same time. So yeah, I thought they were pretty cool to get my hands on. And I think I mentioned in my last video when I did my journal that I used, I actually mentioned this and showed you this, but this is just a little tiny dictionary, a mini dictionary. It's an English dictionary that I found at the junk shop, at a secondhand shop, for $2. So I don't think it was too bad. And I've pulled the cover off and I'm going to make a mini journal. I thought that would be quite cute. But anyway, so I've got that. And what else have I scored? I managed to find this on Trade Me. It is Alice in Wonderland book. So this is the cover, so it's very vintage. Torn apart, so I've taken that off and I took the inside out. It came apart quite easily and it's got the thing on the side, so I thought I might do an Alice in Wonderland journal. I probably will. I just need to get some other bits and pieces, but for now this is what I've got. And I love paper. It doesn't matter what it is, whether it's scrapbook paper, whether it's book paper, whether it's what, I don't know, but the smell of the old vintage paper is just, I don't know, it's just something about it, eh? But yeah, so I got this. So, and there's a picture on the inside. I don't know what year this is actually. So definitely well before my time. I managed to get that, and managed to get these, and this, and this. So another lady on the Happy Mail group, a lady here in New Zealand, sent me some old patterns, which was really cool because I like using the patterns. And I also picked some up from the secondhand shop around the corner from me. So I got some of those. I thought that was really cool. These here I picked up off a website that was closing here in New Zealand, and they just library book cards, you know, from the olden days, and you used to open your book and sit in the stem. I so remember going to the library when I was a kid. And yeah, so I managed to get some of those. They were $1 a packet, which I didn't think was too bad, and there's 10 in a packet. So, and I picked up her last 7 packets that she had, and they're all in the salmon colour. And then she obviously had a few left in other colours that obviously didn't go into a pack, so she sent me those. So I got those. I got a crossword puzzle book from the secondhand shop, so I thought that would come in handy for my junk journals as paper. These here I picked up from the secondhand shop as well, and I thought they were just postcards, but no, and then I didn't read anything. But anyway, when I got home, they're actually blank cards, so but they're definitely old vintage paper cards, so pictures, so I'll be able to use those in my journals as well. So that's pretty cool. And I picked, oh, the lady that sent me from my Happy Mail group that sent me some patterns, she sent me this little music book, which I thought was cool, so I picked that up. So Julia, if you're watching, I've already said thank you, but thank you, because these were great. And then these I picked up from a stationery shop where I live, around the corner from where I live, and they weren't cheap to buy, but finding bits and pieces like this here in New Zealand is a bit difficult. Like, I've seen in some videos with their junk journals, they've got guest checks and other really cool like time cards and all those sorts of things. They're really cool, but I can't find anything like it here in New Zealand, and it's really bugging me. So I am thinking that maybe I should just design my own. But so I picked up these daily time dockets, so you know, for obviously your work and stuff like that. So I used one of these in my journal that I made last time, so but I'm going to scan one in, so when I run out, instead of paying what I paid for them, I'd be able to get maybe 4 on a sheet, so that might be work out cheaper for me. Also, another lady from the Happy Mail group, Nikki Downish Burden, she went to a book fair, book something, and picked up this for me. It's a French dictionary, which is awesome because it's just something different to go on my journal, so I was really chuffed with that. So Nikki, thank you. I know I've said thank you, but thank you. And this was, she actually sent this to me last year, so, but anyway, I love it, it's great. And just some more music sheets really, and some kids books I picked up. This one I picked up, just, yeah, kids stories. And this one was, it was given to somebody, it says, to Robert, wishing him a Merry Christmas from Nelson and Ross, 1945. So this was definitely a vintage book, well before my time. And then this is another little kid's book, but it's a, you know, like a work book that you can do puzzles and bits and pieces in. So I got this. And this one's from 1964, so that's before my time too. And I've already pulled out a bit, and I've already put it through some coffee, so it's definitely changed in colour, so it'll be really cool in a kid's book journal. This is just another music book, and I was looking through this the other day, and I saw a song, Coming Round the Mountain. Who remembers Coming Round the Mountain? Oh my gosh, we used to sing that at school. She'll be coming round the mountain. It was so funny. And then, oh, And then it made me remember of other songs that I sang at school, and then I went onto YouTube and found it, Kenny Rogers singing Gambler. Who remembers that song? My Form 2 teacher was right into us singing, and he played the guitar, and we used to sing the Gambler, Come Round the Mountain. It was so much fun. Anyway. And yeah, just this one is Puff the Magic Dragon. Who remembers that one? I do. I should sing that. I should get my little boy to sing this one. It'd be funny. I'll make my 20-year-old sing it. This one is the Rock and Roll Waltz. Just another music sheet. Oh, and this one's just out of this book that I have had for many, many moons. There's that one. And then there's Your Mother and Mine. So that's just another music sheet. So there's that. And then there's just other stationery bits and pieces that I've collected over the time. I also bought this. It's just a counter book that you can put date, maybe what you sold if you don't have a proper till, something like that, and the price or whatever. And I liked it because I could rip it out, and that could be all ripped, and then I could stain it. So that was $5. So that was a little bit on the dear side, but there's quite a lot in there. Might put you know, attach a few of these into your journals. It'll look quite cool. So yeah, so that is my little haul. I do have some more laces, but I might do that in another haul. I'm not 100% sure, but I've never done a haul video before, and but I had lots of stuff and lots of goodies to show, so I just thought that I would show, since I had a bit of interest from when I put my journal up. I might, when I do my next journal, I will be using some of my own designs, tanyaleigh designs in them, because I think they're absolutely perfect for junk journals. Like I showed you in my last journal, there were some of my designs in there, and I really liked them. I thought they looked really cool, and I will be definitely using more of my designs in my journals. So I will definitely do a flip through of my next journal. I have started one, but I've only just put the papers together, and I've run out of paper, so now I'm in the middle of coffee and tea staining some more papers. So that's what I'm up to. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed my haul video, and I will be back soon with another video. So until then, I will talk to you later. Bye.